Ryder Ministries, a ministry where health, wealth, and wisdom prevails. Ryder Ministries is an international ministry bringing healing, evangelism, and salvation to the nations of the world. Come be a part of this growing outreach where you too can learn to preach, teach, and heal in Jesus' name. Ryder Ministries is a ministry that declares the kingdom of God is the power of God getting results. Now, here's Pastor Robert.
Praise the Lord. I'm Pastor Robert, Ryder Ministries. We are in our second series of Baptism of the Holy Spirit. Father God, we thank you in the name of Jesus for this outpouring of the Spirit, Lord, that will teach us about the baptism. We give you praise and glory for it. We know that you have given to us revelation knowledge, illumination, and comparison in the Word of God. And all the people of God said, yes and amen. One of the biggest things I'm going to be teaching on in this session is so important and so vital is the fact is, why is the baptism of the Spirit so important? Why is it so valuable? Why is it that God has us to pray in tongues now, but not then in the Old Testament? So why is the baptism so important? So let's go over to John chapter 7, verse 37 through 39. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive, for the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. Amen. And then in Acts chapter 1 and verse 4, and being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith, he you have heard of me. So Jesus is sharing with us, it's an important fact to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit because he commanded it. And he said, if you really want and you're thirsty for more, then you need this. All right, so if he's telling us something, we need to obey what it said in the book of Proverbs to listen to every word that he's saying to us. And if a man does, he's that man that's built on a rock. Amen. So the baptism of the Holy Spirit releases power. We see that in the book of Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. But you shall receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in Judea and Samaria and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. So the power of the Lord comes upon you. We've read where Ezekiel, the power of the Lord came upon him and translated him to a different spot in the earth. We see where Samson had the power of the Holy Spirit come upon him and he was able to tear loose some of himself when he's tied up with ropes and all kinds of things. And pick up the gates of the city and move it. I mean, the Holy Ghost has to be working here. But we also see in the baptism of the Holy Spirit, we're having power. It gives you power over the enemy. Gives you power to stop the devil. Yes and amen. And power to heal the sick in Jesus' name. Now, we'll go back to the Old Testament. The Lord told Adam to protect his garden. And we see that in the book of Genesis chapter 2 and 15. And the Lord God took the man, put him into the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. We understand to dress it and to keep it. It's to guard the garden. Now, I'm speaking to the men in this room. If you don't have the baptism of the Holy Spirit functioning in your life, then you're not protecting your wife, which is your garden. It's an important part of a man to understand his power that God has given him to protect his wife. It's really important, okay? Well, we'll go over to 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 7 and 10. For a man indeed ought not to cover his head, for as much as he is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of the man. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. Neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man. For this reason, for this cause, ought the woman to have power on her head, which is her husband, because of the angels. We're not talking good angels. We're talking about the devil. And a woman gets deceived, gets beat up, gets tormented by a devil constantly. And it's up to the man to hear from God, to know what's going on, to put an end to it, say in Jesus' name. So if a husband does not have the power activated in his life, he cannot protect his wife from the angels. Now, Jesus said, we have authority by using his name. Let's go over to Luke chapter 9 and verse 1. Then he called his 12 disciples together and gave them power and authority over all devils and to cure diseases. So we have authority by using the name of Jesus. The authority gives us the legal right to use the power. I'm going to say it again. The authority gives you, the believer, the legal right to use the power that God just gave you. Say, thank you, Lord. That's why we use the name of Jesus. Now, the baptism of the Holy Spirit gives us authority. Let's look in Luke 10:19. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. So the baptism of the Holy Spirit gives you authority over all devils. How many understand? All devils. I don't care where you are in the world, there's a devil somewhere. But I have the authority and the power and the legal right to use that power. And why does Pastor Robert constantly want you to pray in tongues after we sing to get you to be using your authority? Get you to understand that when you start doing this, you're going to start hearing the voice of the Lord. You're going to identify that you have the power to beat. The devil's going to show you a devil working here, and it's up to you to do something about it. But if you don't know how to use the power, the legal right to use it, nothing's going to happen, and you're just going to be beat up. And God's wanting us to understand we have authority over all devils. There's not one that doesn't understand that. All right? So what's really exciting, the Lord promised that he would pour out his Spirit. All right? We see that in Joel chapter 2 and 28. And he shall come, and it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. Isn't this good news? I see dreams and visions, so I must be young. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. The God poured out his Spirit upon all flesh. It's available today in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Now, Peter quoted this scripture, but he changed the word. And I want you to see that. In Acts chapter 2 and 17. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. You go, what? Let me read you Joel. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my Spirit. What Peter said, I will pour out of my Spirit. So it's like taking a pitcher, which is the Holy Ghost, pouring it into a glass. That glass becomes full. You take that glass, now you pour it into another glass. You take that glass and you pour it into another glass. So the Holy Spirit was poured out, but it's poured into us, and we pour it out into other people. So that's how Paul went about laying his hands on the people, and they got baptized with the Holy Spirit. Today, we start seeing more and more people speaking in tongues, say, thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. So Peter said that the Spirit has come on all flesh. So the Holy Spirit is available. All you got to do is get Jesus in your heart. Then you can have the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And I always tell people, you can't have the baptism of the Holy Spirit because it's members only. And the only way you can have the baptism of the Holy Spirit, members only, is to be born again with Jesus. So if it's only members only and you get baptized in the Holy Spirit, you know you're saved. Amen. See, and you can't get rid of the baptism of the Holy Spirit because you got it. So which means you can't lose your salvation. So once saved, always say, amen.
Amen.
So the promise is for all people who are born again. Let's look in John chapter 3, verse 5 through 12. Jesus answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it lists, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, how can these things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, art thou a master of Israel, and knowest not these things? Better be knowing. I'm looking at myself. Am I a master? I better know. Are you a master? You better know some stuff. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and you receive not our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and you believe not, how should you believe if I tell you of heavenly things? Then we see in Titus chapter 3, verse 4 through 6, but after that the kindness and love of God our Savior toward man appeared, that would be Jesus, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost. It's a good news. Which he shed on us abundantly through Jesus Christ our Savior. Then we see in John 14, verse 17, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but you know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. In Acts chapter 2, 38 to 39, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins. Get born again. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you, and to your children, and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Say, good news. Almost done. So the baptism is for the Gentiles as well as for the Jews. And we see that in Acts chapter 10, verse 44 through 47. While Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on them which heard the word. And they of the circumcision which believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. For they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. Then answered Peter, can any man forbid water that these should not be baptized which have received the Holy Ghost as we? So in other words, you can get water baptized first and then get baptized with the Holy Ghost. You can get baptized with the Holy Ghost first and then get baptized with water. It doesn't make any difference as long as you get it all. Say, thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. So the baptism is for believers in Acts chapter 19, verse 2 through 6. Paul speaking, and he said to them, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believed? I use that on everyone I talk to. Have you received the Holy Ghost since you believed? And they look at you like, what? I'm quoting scripture. And they said unto him, we have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Ghost. And he said unto them, unto then were you baptized? And they said, unto John's baptism. Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is, on Christ Jesus. So you got to believe on Jesus, okay? When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. They were saying, the Lord, come save me, repent for my sins. This is a sinner's prayer. Baptism in Jesus' name is how you get born again. And when Paul had laid his hands upon them, the Holy Ghost came on them, and they spoke with tongues and prophesied. Isn't that good news? So Jesus is our baptizer. So you want to know if Jesus ever shows up in front of your face? Yeah, when you get baptized with the Holy Ghost. Let's see what it says in Mark chapter 1 and verse 8. I indeed have baptized you with water, but he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost. So we know it's Jesus that's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost. We see that also in Acts chapter 1, verse 4 through 5. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. Isn't that good news? Praise the Lord. So, in Acts chapter 2 and verse 4, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. So, when we ask the Lord for anything, we know that we receive. As we receive the baptism, there is a God's part and there is our part. Our part is the speaking part. The Lord's part is giving all who ask. Now, I learned something on this last scripture. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And the Lord had me read that over and over again. I was meditating on this for quite a while. And then all of a sudden, the Lord unlocked the scripture just like that. Okay? So, our part, begin to speak. God's part, Spirit giving. Our part, begin to speak. Holy Spirit's part gave them the utterance. Utterance is a language. It's not I ain't speaking in tongues. Speaking in tongues is a language. You're enunciating and you are speaking loudly. You are baptized with the Holy Spirit and you're proud of it in Jesus' name. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to have you sit where you are and we're all going to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit one more time. And you're going to be refilled like the Holy Spirit did with the disciples. And as He fills you, fill up. Begin to speak aloud. Declare what God has put in your heart. Listen to what the Spirit has taught you, why the baptism is so important. I mean, I know there's more to this because I got two more sessions to teach. So I want everybody to repeat with me. Say, Father God,
thank you
for the greatest gift on earth. And that's the gift of salvation. Lord Jesus, you said you promised us another gift. And that's the gift of the Holy Spirit. I ask you, Jesus, to baptize me with the Holy Spirit so I can speak in tongues right now. Thank you, Jesus. You did your part. Now I'm going to do my part. I'm going to raise my hands to God. I'm going to begin to worship the Lord in my new heavenly language. On the count of three, begin. One, two, three. Ah, oh, so, ba, sha, la, bro, so, la, ma, sa. Ye, de, la, bron, so, do, ba, ba, da, sha, na, na, ma, sa. De, bron, do, o, sho, do, la, bra, sa, na, na, ma, sa. Ye, de, la, bro, so, do, sho, do, la, bra, sha, la, na, ma, sa. Ye, de, la, bron, do, so, do, re, bra, sa, ye, de, la, ba, so, na, na, ma. Ye, de, la, bro, sho, do, la, bra. Get, start speaking, because I'm going to ask every one of you to hear it. Ye, de, la, bro, sho, la, bra, sha, ya, da, la, na, ma, so. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now I have received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Tell Him that. I have received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now you can sing in tongues. You can whisper in tongues. You can yell in tongues. And we'll let you do that on your own. So right now I'm going to end. So I say thank you, Father, to each and every one here. Receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. You put in them knowledge of the reason for it. So important for them to receive. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that we are able to interpret our tongues now in Jesus' name. And all the people of God said, yes and amen and amen.
Thank you for watching and participating with Pastor Robert in this tremendous
Praise
teaching. As you practice putting into place these biblical truths, you will develop your human spirit as a mighty believer in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm Pastor Robert with Ryder Ministries. We're glad that you watched our latest video, and we want to invite you to become a partner with our ministry. Partnerships mean that you pray one for another. We pray for you. You pray for us. You send us a seed offering, we'll send you a DVD. Our DVDs will help you to become ministers of God. And as a partner, we'll also notify you when we have our next healing explosions in your area. Or we'll let you know where they are so you can come and participate with us in Jesus' name. We want to teach you to become God's minister, healing the sick, casting out devils, the things that Jesus did. Amen. Our ministry is to help the body of Christ to grow and become what God has called each person to be in Jesus' name. So we're asking you to be part of our 250 partners this year. Let us know. So give us a call at 503-652-2650 or get on our website and check out Ryder.org. You'll be surprised of all the goodies we have on there just for you.
So we thank you for being our partners. We invite you to come back and see us more often. God bless you.
We invite you to join us again in learning God's Word with these awesome video teachings. You can visit us on the web for more of God's revelation and biblical truths at Ryder.org. That's Ryder.org. And join us again next time for more of Ryder Ministries with Pastor Robert Ryder.